Hello. Hi. We need to wait for the notification to go out. Let me tweet something real quick. Hello. How are you guys? Detective Dream, yes. Today we have some detective work we need to do. Hello. I didn't make this skin, by the way. I just found this skin. It's pretty cool though. I don't know. With my little detective hat. My little monocle, I think. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. Welcome. I need to wait for the notification to go out. Then we will begin our detective work. How loud's the music? Let me see. What's the music? Let me see. Quiet. Okay, I'm turning it up. Does that make it louder? I can't tell. Is that louder? Guys, how's the music? Alright, there you go. Is the music good now? Is it good? I can't tell. Louder? Louder than that? Or is it good? Say yes if it's loud now. Is it loud now? Or is it good? Alright, I'm gonna listen to it now. Okay, it's good now. Alright, there we go, perfect. Alright. Hello! How are you guys doing? Oh, but now it's loud for me. Maybe if I don't know how this works. All right, there we go. That's fine. All right. Hello. Are you loving the fit? Yeah, it's pretty good. It's pretty good. All right. This is Detective Dream. This is my Detective Dream skin. Skin is so cute. Thank you. All right, I'm just waiting for all the notifications to go out, the viewers to pile in, you know, all that good stuff. Fit check. This is my fit. That looks funny. All right. All right. Okay, here we go. All right. So today, listen, today. Oh, this isn't fitting music. Today, we have some detective work to do. Okay? We have some detective work. And Detective Dream is on the case. There's been some drama. There's been commentary videos. There's been drama, as always, on Twitter, because Twitter sucks for drama. There's always drama. There's always drama going on. But Detective Dream is on the case. I have like a soundboard. I'll never use a soundboard. That's so funny. Okay, so listen. I'm on the case. Detective Dream is here. That's why the stream is called Detective Dream, and that's why my my skin is Detective Dream. I think the notification has gone out. Say yes if you came through notification, and say no if you just you came because I don't know. You're awesome, and you I don't know. You just were already here or something. I don't know. Yes. Okay. Notification is out. All right. So listen. We need to do some detective work. So that's what we're going to do today. This is going to be a summary and detective work into the drama that's been going on. I don't know. I feel like it's quiet. The music's quiet. I don't know, though. Well, there we go. Is the music quiet? I don't know. All right. Here we go. All right. So Detective Dream had some business to attend to. This is what happened. So we're gonna go over the timeline. The timeline is this, okay? Here's the timeline. 1 year ago. You can't hear the music? Oh really? You're kidding me. Come on, the music is a part of it. Is that good? That good now? That's worse? I turned it up. How can it be worse? You're lying to me. You guys are lying to me. Open my volume mixer. Where? Hard to hear. Weird. Let me see if I check on Streamlabs. You guys are lying. Is it fixed now? Is it good? Just low. I can like, it's so loud to me. I can hear it. All right, I'm turning up this. Can I add like a volume filter or something? Wait, oh god, okay, now you guys are saying perfect, but now, okay, what about now? I just made it much louder, probably. Is it too loud now? Loud, okay, filters. I'm sorry. Alright, is this good? That's good, right? Is that good? Alright, we need too loud or yes, or is it still too loud? You're helping me fix it. Okay, it's too loud. Still too loud, okay. All right, there we go. This is good. Okay, so listen, here we go. It's Detective Dream on the case, all right? So recently, we'll start from the beginning. We have to go back. 1 year ago, I did a collaboration with a small YouTuber. It was 1 year ago, it was February, or no, it was before that, but I did a collaboration. I had like a million subscribers or something like that. And a small documentary channel reached out to me. They had 6,000 subscribers. You know, I thought it'd be cool. I thought it'd be a good idea. I decided to do a collaboration. It was cool. The video was good. It was a good video. The collaboration was great. I had a good time. You know, it worked out really well, and I don't know, the guy seemed like a nice guy. You know, I didn't really talk to him or anything. I talked to him only during the documentary, but that was it. Seemed pretty nice, you know. And then 3 months later, that's when drama struck. So I get a DM. Let me see, can I pull up these DMs here? No, I can't, I don't have it. I got a DM from somebody who messaged me and said, somebody is impersonating you. It was crazy. It was actually insane. I didn't know what to think. I was like, somebody's impersonating me, what? And so I get screenshots of this impersonation account saying I was gonna make a sex Minecraft mod, a realistic one, and saying the N-word and saying other things. And then I get a DM also from the same person saying, that it was the person that I did the documentary channel that was doing it. So, I reach out to this person. They said interesting things. Let's pull up the DMs. I said, are you DMing people about me? He said, wait, what? I haven't been on Discord in a bit. He said, okay, I can't log in. That's actually very weird. You got messages from me? I would like to underline something. Discord. I did not mention Discord. I said, no, someone else did. He said, okay, that's weird. I've got to sort that out because I didn't send any. I've not been on for 3 days. I said lots of weird messages about how we're friends, I hate Skeppy, and that I'm working on a sex mod and me saying the N-word, stuff like that. He said, okay, I definitely didn't send any of those. Unless the person who told you that is delusional. Kind of weird. Unless the person told you that's delusional, I don't know. Whatever. Okay, I got back in. 10 minutes. Interesting. Apologies, man. They will be duly lectured. One of my IRLs decided it was a good idea to F with my YouTube. He says he meant Discord. Account where I had it signed in on their PC. It gets deeper. It gets deeper than this, though. I didn't really believe them. I thought it's like the dog ate your homework. Like, no, it was my brother who got on my computer and DM'd you the N-word. Like, okay, I didn't really believe it. I mean, that was my perspective, but I didn't say anything. As you can see, I didn't reply. There's no, okay, well, you can pretend. There's nothing there, because I did not reply. The DMs were empty. I didn't reply. I'd never interacted with the person for a whole year. This was an entire year ago. As you can see, February 8th, 2020. Not 2021, 2020. So recently, why has this been brought up, you ask? It's been 1 year, it's been an entire year. I made the mistake of expressing an opinion on the internet. Yes, I know. Terrible, horrible. I apologize. I'd like to formally apologize for expressing an opinion on the internet. Let's go over that opinion. Dream has made accusations about me on Reddit to try and smear my credibility. So I will respond here in detail to ensure that everything is perfectly clear. This was my message. This guy is bad news. Okay, first of all, context. I was replying this on a Reddit with 4,000 users that was a criticism subreddit for me in a comment that had 21 likes when he posted this thread with 3,500 likes. Anyway, I said, this guy is bad news. A while back, right after I interviewed with him for a Minecraft documentary, he changed his profile picture and name on Discord to mine and started DMing people pretending to be me. He sent people the N-word and a lot of other stuff, as well as said sexual stuff while claiming that it was me, and giving his main Twitter to vouch. Where he would then, from his main Twitter, vouch that it was me and say that we were amazing friends and link the documentary to prove it. That's a tough accusation, right? But given the fact that it happened, I mean, anyway, once I confronted him about it, very nice given the circumstances. As you can see, I was very nice. We can go back to the DMs. I was very nice. I mean, I just said, are you DMing people about me? I did the little bad boy Halo face. No, someone else did. Lots of weird messages and nothing else. I didn't say screw you. I didn't expose him. I didn't post anywhere. I was very nice. I was nice. He said that his friend had hacked his accounts and done it. That's true. That is what he said. So everything I said is factual. I didn't reply to him, also true, and unfollowed him. Okay, I'm not sure that was true because he told me he didn't think I followed him ever. I thought I did, maybe I didn't. And I don't think he is super fond of me since then. That's also true because he's tweeted out that I'm a scumbag and other stuff recently. I'm not even here to talk about that though. I didn't even know about that originally. until I saw this post on Reddit that I replied to. So he got 20 upvotes, so he made this thread. Said, back probably a year ago, I was visiting some family friends. One of the guys I was talking to was much younger than me and wanted to know about YouTube and what I did to make videos. Since I didn't have my PC with me, I logged into Discord on his laptop and showed him some things that I had screenshotted and sent other people before I left. I foolishly didn't log out of my account. He decided it would be a good idea to start trolling on my account with his friends and used an alt account as well as my account to have conversations with about three different people. One of these was Harley. This will be important later. He used an alt account, changed his name in PFP to Dream, and started saying some really strange stuff. It was like 12-year-old humor, like the N-word. 12-year-old humor. I was told the N-word was said, but I have seen no evidence of that. Well, let's see the we'll see the evidence shortly. But I did find convos about a Minecraft sex mod and other weird shit. All right. This is where it gets interesting. You may think it can't get more interesting than this. This is already super interesting, Dream. How can it get more interesting? But I'm telling you, it gets more interesting. It gets much more interesting. So he has claimed, obviously, that this man was not him. So let's find out. This is Detective Dream. That's why we have Detective Dream here on the case, because we need to figure out, was it him? Was it his cousin? Was it a sister? Was it a family friend? Was it a 12-year-old? Let's find out. We're finding out together. We have all the information. We have the receipts. We have the screenshots. Let's work it out together. All right. Back to the screenshots. All right, here we go. All right. Let's start the investigation. All right, here we go. Copyright, by the way. He messages Harley. This is the day of the hack. He said, hello. Harley said, hi. He said, what's up? Harley said, nothing much. Just wanted to add you because you seem fun to talk to. They had priorly talked on Twitter, but not on Discord. He said, things not working out with LT Cobra. For context, LT Cobra is a friend of Harley's that John Swan knew about and was a prior relationship, knowing that Harley was having issues with LT Cobra. Interesting. So apparently, Swan claimed to me earlier today that this was his 12-year-old friend that he hasn't spoken to in a year. How? I ask you, how would his 12-year-old friend know about Harley's relationship with LT Cobra? That doesn't line up to me. I'd just like to say that it does not really line up to me. I mean, that is an interesting scenario, unless his 12-year-old friend somehow knew about this, because they had no prior Discord messages. None. At all. Zero. Actually, none. So he couldn't even do research, because Harley's old account was actually suspended. All right. Let's move on. And these messages are kind of weird anyway, but not talk about that. Oh, this is very epic. So what are you up to on this fine day, Mr. Swan? I'm in a call with Dream at the moment. He was not in a call with me. Dream was taken. Yup. Keep that in mind. Now, what would you say? I mean, would you say yes, yep? Would you say yup? I mean, maybe. Maybe you're one of the people in the world that say yup, right? Maybe you are. Keep that in mind. Keep in mind, yup. Let's do a language analysis. Keep in mind, yup. Keep that yup in mind, okay? Now, I have never, as far as I know, said yup in my entire life. So, I rest my case. Okay, no, I don't rest my case. That's not it. That's actually not it. If that was it, that's probably enough, but that's not it. That's not it. He says yup. So, that's in his vocabulary. That's an interesting thing. Very interesting. He happens to say yup. His 12-year-old friend happens to say yup, just like him. Let's continue. Cool. I've always wanted to meet him. His videos are interesting. I can never tell if it's a joke or serious anymore. Well, I mean, it depends on the video. Does he actually have a Discord server? I do. Yes, I do. I'm not in it if he does. Is his Discord account private? We're starting over. I interviewed him for my Minecraft documentary, and we've become such good friends since. I mean, good friends, I wouldn't say, unless I'm good friends with everybody in this chat, which obviously, according to Ludwig, I am not, and I would agree, I'm not. He said, no idea. Harley said, that sounds pretty fun. Can I get his Discord? It's up to you, but I would love to learn more about how he develops his plugins. I am making my own game in Unity. Impressive. I'd like to ask him questions about how to do some stuff with that too. I wouldn't know. Anyway, that's not the point. Swan said, yeah, sure, give me a sec. Okay, awesome, thanks. All right, move on, next messages. Ha ha ha, oops, we skipped some messages here. So he said in these messages, let me see if I have them. Let me check real quick if I have these messages. Where would I have these messages? Do I have them? I might. He told me. Where is he? Okay, so they're missing messages, but they are here. I have them on a notepad on my phone. Let me go ahead and check this notepad on my phone. He said, what did he say? He said, Harley said, what have you done today? Anything interesting? And Swan said, yeah, I just recorded an exposed video on Skeppy. Harley said, ha ha ha, he's a funny guy. And John said, also scummy. Skeppy, scummy. Yeah, I don't think he's... Nah. Harley said, ha 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 ha, you did an exposed video? What did you expose him for? Swan said, he steals code. Interesting. Interesting 12-year-old. Keep in mind, this is a 12-year-old, according to John Swan. 12-year-old. He steals code. Let's look at this verbiage. Exposed video. Now, if I was saying that, I would say expose video. Expose video. I don't know what you would say. Maybe you would say exposed video. But let's just say maybe the odds are 50-50. Maybe the odds are 50-50. Let's see what John Swan himself says. And there's plenty more where this came from. I mean, he's used this vernacular plenty of times. Exposed videos, exposed video. I mean, it's just the D. That's the only thing I'm interested in. The D. I would do that without the D. Exposed video. Maybe you wouldn't. Maybe it's 50-50. Maybe it's 50-50. I'll give him the benefit of the doubt and say, maybe he happens to have, yup, exposed video, maybe, who knows. Anyway, he said, and he spams uploads with duplicate content against YouTube's terms of service. That is a smart 12-year-old who happens to know YouTube. After having apparently asked Swan about YouTube and talked to him for 10 seconds. Anyway. Okay, let's move on. He steals code, though. This is important, because this is a relevant thing from back then. It's relevant. Because back then, people were saying, oh, Skeppy steals code in his videos and things like that, in the commentary community, which just so happens to be the community that Mr. Swan resides in. Anyway, let's just say, 12-year-old understands. He understands the commentary community. He's in on the know. He knows all of that. He knows about the YouTube TOS. You should enforce TOS across all levels. He has impeccable, I don't know, like spelling and grammar and I don't know. Let's move on. I was just talking to Dream about him. No, you weren't. But YouTube won't. He agrees. No, I don't. I asked for a DM to verify it's him. Kind of sketchy. He DM'd me.
Okay. Okay.
Fair enough. It's him. It's not. Then record a few seconds of audio. Dude, I literally interviewed him for my Minecraft documentary. Have you watched the video? Doesn't mean this isn't a dummy account from one of your friends. What? Dude, this is stupid. You can make a fake account to copy it, though. Dream doesn't DM people the N-word and shit. That is true. That is very true. I don't. I will publicly officially say that I do not do that. That is definitely not. Oh, he DM'd you that. Lamau. Haha, that was for me. Ha. I have his Discord. It's like I know that's not him. Well, obviously you don't because you asked me for it. I mean, that's some high-level sarcasm. I mean, well, obviously you don't because you asked me for it. If you asked me for it, you wouldn't have Discord. That's some smack talk. Swan's going for the takedown, the WWE smackdown. But is this a 12-year-old? That's the question.
Okay.
Anyway, I wanted to verify validity. Swan, yeah, he's talking about you. Dude, you don't have to be a dick. Obviously, he doesn't want him DMing me. I am not. It's just real suspicious. If it's really him, get him to respond to my DM on Twitter. I think he stopped caring about you. That's a fake. He's a busy man. He's not interested in clout chasers. So then, what if I told you I am a $35 supporter to his Patreon? Patreon.com/stream was taken. He said that, it's just not there. And have access to his private Dream supporters server. And he has a different hashtag. Then I would tell you that he has two accounts. Interesting. Let's move on. Let's see what else we have here. This is later. I mean, it's just him doing the ha-ha-ha-ha thing. A lot of people do that. It's not much. But again, it's just when you have similar, like, you have a similar speech to somebody else, it's just, I don't know. It's interesting. It's very interesting. I mean, he says ha-ha-ha, he says ha-ha-ha-ha, which obviously, and that's the real John, by the way. This is confirmed real John. And then, according to him, this is fake John. I mean, I'm not saying that means anything, but it means something. But, like, you can add it all together. I mean, it's just, it doesn't mean much, but it still does mean something. This is just all my research. I mean, I did research. I did plenty of research into this subject, okay? But the smoking gun is yet to come. The smoking gun is yet to come. He said, I don't care about that. I don't want to end careers. Just be honest. I know that isn't Dream. Dude, I don't care. What else do you want from me? I don't know. Just be honest. It ain't Dream. Okay, dude. Whatever you say. I just know I interviewed him for my Minecraft documentary and became good friends with him afterwards. That's all. That's a fake account, though. I mean, Harley seems like very smart. Harley is persistent. Harley's not taking bullshit, right? Harley is going at him. He's like, no, this is fake. I know it's fake. Stop telling me it's real. Even though he's made a video with me, he was not taking mess. He was going for it. He's popping off. And then Harley DMs and says, so now what? And sent screenshots of me saying it wasn't me. They just like ended his career. He got him with the, so this you? This you? And this was a day later. This, because they're in weird time. And they have like the 8 that goes first. Pop off. It's 4K. 4K resolution. It was me saying, not me. As you can see with all these pixels, that says not me. You can read it. Anyway, we move on. This is a day later. He says, can I call you about this? As this is relatively serious. I'd just like to confirm you haven't been hacked. I need to call you. This is a day later. I mean, it's been a whole day. This has been happening. I need to call you to confirm it's you. What? Mate, don't spam me. Sorry, I'm at a party, mate. Anyway. Sorry, I'm at a party, mate. Will you be home anytime soon? I just need to verify it's you. Is there any way that you can prove you are 100% John Swan, so that the argument that you've been hacked goes out the window? If you are John, unless you've been behind the Dream fake account, you'd have no reason to not confirm who you are. And then he gets unhacked, and he gets access to his account, apparently. He says, so it's real you now, right, Swan? Yeah, okay, nice. Can we call at any point soon just so I can go over all the stuff that was said and hear how you feel about this and shit? From like the Dream 2 account, you can see stuff. He says, another time, mate! This is not John. This is John. This is not John. Apparently. I'm not saying he's lying. I'm saying this is not John. This is John. Okay. Move on. This is the same thing. This is from earlier. I'm gonna call with him. With a screenshot. Obviously, this is not my Discord icon. I don't have my Dream icon. That's just interesting. One mic's lit up, one mic's not. The mic is not muted. Two different people, most likely. Neither mics are muted. You see a mic icon here if it's muted. Two different people. Interesting. Keep that in mind. Most likely, two different people in on this meme. Let's move on. These are the messages. These are the messages. Between fake Dream. Ignore this. Ignore this for now. This is the new name on the account. Ignore this. This is fake Dream. Hi. And he goes, oh, I want to get in contact with you, blah, blah, blah. Sorry, wrong person. Oh, because he just sent the N-word. And then he said, sorry, wrong person. But it got deleted because he deleted it. Anyway, yeah, my day has been good. Thanks for asking. Just got finished up with this Minecraft sex mod. It's looking really realistic. What? Huh. Is this going to be a video? This is, by the way, this used to be me. This used to be Dream with a Dream profile picture. Anyway. Well, of course. I think it will bang. YouTube algorithm finna slaughter you. True, Harley. True. Harley is coming out of this on top, looking very intelligent. Not sure what's funny about it. I've put a lot of time and effort into perfecting this. I think it's gonna be one of my proudest pieces of code. Sounds it. I'm guessing you ain't the real Dream, because you don't have social link, but this discussion is funny, so I would like to continue it. True, true. Very smart. Check in the socials. Check in the list and check in it twice. The reason I do not have my socials linked is because I don't like my close friends knowing I have a YouTube channel. Very good excuse. Good excuse. You're pulling it together. I only really use this account for my IRLs, but you added some random person. Okay, whatever. Good enough. But you're the same name. If they search anywhere, they'll find you. Not to worry about that, lol. Okay, I will DM you on Twitter. Could you respond? It's not happened yet. Oh, okay, because I'm from above. Anyways, I guess John has wasted my time by telling me to add you. It seems like you're just here to criticize my work and throw comments about the validity of my account. No, I am not. I want to know how you make them, but I need verification it's you. That's reasonable. So this is what matters the most. But thank you. Interesting. Nicholas Diorio. Who's that? Well, that is the new name on the fake Dream account. The new name. It has a new name and profile picture. That's how Discord works. But Harley was able to find the old account. And it has the new name, Nicholas Diorio. Instead of Dream with a Dream profile picture. So who is Nicholas, you may ask? That is a good question. This is Nicholas. Drama YouTuber. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, this is Nicholas. That's interesting. Why is the old fake Dream account now called Nicholas? Let's see. Let's head to Nicholas's YouTube. Let's see. I'm going on his second YouTube account. His most recent posts. He has Old Town Road cover, John Swan. Homicide cover, John Swan. I'm Alex's next victim. There's some other ones. This isn't John Swan. This is John Swan's best friend. His best friend. So, my question is, how is it all linked? How is it all linked? We need to connect the dots, right? The dots have to be connected. So what we know is the new name on the account, which wasn't changed after this was brought up. It was not changed after this was brought up. It was not. Harley was able to confirm that with screenshots and witness testimony from that before this all happened, this name was Nicholas Diorio. So that's interesting. Very interesting. Why is the new account that used to be called Dream, that was an alt account, apparently of this 12-year-old who is a family friend, called Nicholas Diorio, John Swan's best friend? They've been friends for a long time, from what I did my research. They've been tweeting about each other. I had a secret account, joined their Discord, and look at their messages. It seemed interesting. They seemed like very good friends. Very good friends. So, why would this randomly be? So, these are the scenarios here. One. The 12-year-old is a genius, a mad genius, who knows how to perfectly mimic John Swan's vernacular, his mannerisms, the way he speaks, has information about Harvey's friends without ever having spoken to him before, and have no past messages, that then now, a year later, is still a criminal mastermind using Nicholas Diorio's name on the old fake Dream account. For some reason, a man with 50,000 YouTube subscribers who has no relevance to this situation other than that he is John Swan's friend. Or it was John Swan. Now, which is more likely? That is not for me to decide. For you. It's for you to decide. But we have more. We have some more. That's not it. That it gets juicier. It gets juicier. Back to stage one. I can't log in. He left his account signed in on a 12-year-old's computer, and he can't log in. Well, that's not how that works. If you left your account on somebody else's computer, then you can still log in. It's just they can log in too. I mean, it's not like he knew your password and was able to change your password or anything, and you had to submit a password request or anything. Huh. Well, let's see what he said about that. Let's go ahead and check out and see what he said about that. Let me go to his replies real quick. Let me find it. He said, let's see where it is. All right, there is screenshot. Wait a second, it's just loading. All right. Go. I actually can't remember why I wasn't able to get in. Maybe bad connection. The House of Cards falls. It continues to fall. You cannot build a house of lies without having inconsistency after inconsistency after inconsistency. Allegedly. Maybe bad connection. Maybe bad connection to the point where I had to submit a password reset request. Right? Maybe. Maybe I was trying to act like I was hacked, but at the same time claiming that I left it on someone else's computer, which doesn't work because you don't need to reset your password using a password reset request if you have access to the account. And you don't need to have, if you have bad connection, that doesn't mean you don't have access to the account, in which he claims he has access to the account. And if you left it on a PC, on their PC, that doesn't mean that you can't log in. I mean, and he submitted a password request. Now, apparently, according to Harley, the Savage, they said that he originally claimed it was his cousin. Apparently, he said to someone else that it was his sister. He said to me it was a family friend that he hasn't spoken to. He went on record yesterday saying he has not spoken to this person that is a family friend, not related to him at all, apparently. That's 12 years old, that he says has autism, which I don't know why he told me that, but I'm just passing on all the information he's given me. That has now, apparently having not spoken in a year to this person, is now apparently framing a random commentary YouTuber, Nicholas Dioria, with 50,000 subscribers. So make it make sense. Make it make sense. Because it doesn't. It doesn't make any sense. The dots, they none of them connect. None of them connect to each other. Somehow Nicholas Dioria is the account that used to be Dream, and like that's random. It's like his best friend. Like, so this is my theory. This is my theory. John Swan saw an opportunity to troll, and he took it. Decided to troll. He was probably in a call with his friend Nicholas Dioria. Decided to troll. Nicholas then you know, messaged him as Dream and said some dumb stuff. And they were just making, you know, they were having fun, other than the fact that they sent the N-word. They were messing around. They said some dumb Minecraft sex mod stuff. And then they forgot about it. And changed it back. Now, this isn't his main Discord account. This is not his main Discord account. It's not. It's not his main Discord account. Because I've confirmed that this is not his main Discord account. But could be an alt or something. But this name being here makes no sense whatsoever. Other than that, it's either John on his an alt, which is could be likely, except for this. Which I talked about earlier. His mic not muted. His mic not muted. He's talking. He's not lighting up. This is John Swan. Who's this? Nicholas. Maybe. Not, you know, not showing any, not throwing any accusation out there, but that's just a theory. A game theory. My final piece of evidence. This account. Although the account was recently cleared out and left all their Discord servers, they weren't quick enough. They were not quick enough. Harley was able to confirm that this account, Nicholas Diorio, was in one Discord that was shared with Harley. It was a YouTuber Discord that happened to have John Swan and Nicholas. Nicholas's actual Discord account and this one in the Discord. So let's just go over the evidence from the beginning, real briefly. First, John Swan claims that he left his account on a 12-year-old family friend's computer who he hasn't spoke to since this incident and has no idea, you know, any involvement he has, no idea anything he did, that then decided to make a fake Dream account as well as use John Swan's main account to troll a random person, Harley. And then, on top of that, decided to act just like John. Say things that John would only know about, like LT Cobra, that John in relation to Harley, that Harley confirmed John would only know about. Would use common phrases and vernacular that John Swan uses, like yup. And other things like exposed video and things like that. Mentioning the YouTube TOS and specific things from it, like duplicate content. Knowing Skeppy uploaded a lot at the time. You should enforce the TOS across all levels. Using intense sarcasm. Well, obviously you don't know because you had to ask me for it. Using grammar on a computer, nonetheless. Grammarly must have been installed. That's what we learned. Don't. Good grammar. You know, punctuation. Even in situations where, you know, you wouldn't have expected it before. Like when he says, like, where does he say it? At the moment. He puts a period after it. Kind of weird. This 12-year-old, very smart. Or it's not a 12-year-old. This went on for 2 days. This is 8. This is 7. He's able to get back access to his account very quickly. He said, "Don't spam me. I'm at a party." This 12-year-old is a party animal.
uses the same phrasing again. Uses mate. Same grammar. Punctuation. Punctuation. Capitals. Capitals. It's the exact same as this 12-year-old. Capitals. Even on the a capital. This is the same punctuation later. That's definitely, it's obviously him. You know nothing about growth, blah, 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 whatever. And then the fake account changed to the best friend of John Swan, Nicholas Diorio, randomly. This 12-year-old has decided to, pretend to be a 50,000 subscriber commentary YouTuber that's friends with John Swan, because, he wanted to, before any of this happened. John Swan said he didn't lose access, but he requested a password reset, and he sent it as proof that he lost access. He said he just had bad internet connection, and that's why he couldn't connect to his account, and that it wasn't actually lost. And he then used Harley to say that Harley had changed their opinion, and that Harley thought that it wasn't him anymore, even though Harley made a video back then that John did not like at all and said some interesting things to Harley about. But Harley has tweeted recently, after speaking to Dream, I'm unlisting my video and I won't be saying anything further at this point. I'll leave my prior statements up. Just know I'm not confident in them anymore. His key witness has backed out after hearing the information that was presented. So, ladies and gentlemen, caught in 4K. That's all I have to say, okay? Caught in 4K. I mean, I will say, I usually don't express negative opinions like this. I posted a comment on a subreddit in a comment. A comment that had 20 likes. And somehow it became like this huge YouTube that like 15 commentary channels make like 100,000 view videos on, saying Dream is manipulative and he's a liar. We can revisit the original comment I made. Everything I said was true. Every single thing. And even John agrees with everything I said. He just says, well, it wasn't me. I said that you said it wasn't you. I said he said that his friend hacked his account and done it. What was I lying about? I even gave you the benefit of the doubt and put that information there that you claimed it wasn't you. And I didn't even express opinion. I didn't go, oh, he said it wasn't him, but I know it was him. I just said I didn't reply and I unfollowed him. That's all I said. I implied, but somehow this turned into me getting exposed, because everybody has to turn everything into drama on Twitter nowadays. So look, I'll say this, I gave John every opportunity, to be honest. I gave him every opportunity. I messaged him, I had conversations with him, I was telling him, hey look, dude, like, I know it was you. I know it was you on the account. Like, there's heaps of evidence that either it was you or you're just not telling us the full story. I gave him opportunity. I was like, look, I don't want to cause problems. I don't want to cause anything to happen. I'd rather just us work it out, and I want to know what's going on. And he's like, okay, well, I have nothing to say. And I was like, okay, fair enough. I tried my best. That's why I made this stream, because I just hate when people think that, I don't know, like, it's very frustrating. Everything, like, a comment with 21 likes became like this million view catastrophe on YouTube with tons of channels and tweets, and I'm a liar apparently for nothing. But anyway, that is it. That's all. So, Detective Dream, that's it. That's the case. Now look, I'm perfectly fine. Form your opinions if you want. If you disagree with me after seeing all that evidence, that's fine. If you think you want to give him the benefit of the doubt, that's fine. I'm not a liar, though. I'm not a liar. And it's perfectly reasonable for me to assume that he was being dishonest. And not even tell anybody that. But just assume that he was probably being dishonest. Based on everything that I knew and everything that I had seen, it was reasonable. It was reasonable. So even if you don't think that's enough to convince you for whatever reason, or you don't like me and that, so you're going to stick to that opinion, that's fine. That's fine. I'm not a liar. I did not lie about that. I was telling the truth about everything that I said, and I was sharing my opinion. And opinions on the internet don't really work anymore, but that's that. So, Detective Dream, all I really had to say. Thank you for watching. Like I said, feel free to form your own opinion. I've expressed mine. You know, I'm not a god. I'm not an always right being or something. You can form your own opinion. I just think, personally, as an analytical and logical thinker, that there is... It's obvious. It's very obvious. And after I talked to Harley for 10 minutes afterwards, Harley was basically saying the same thing. But, yeah. That's my viewpoint. I'm going to raid Tubbo. Thank you guys for watching. Detective Dream out. Hopefully I don't have to come out again. But, you know, Detective Dream is on the case. You know? Detective Dream is efficient and effective and gets the job done. So that's all I have to say. Obviously, I'm joking. Either way. That was fun. Bye!